Maestro! Maestro! Don't you remember me?
No, who the devil are you?
I'm your pupil. Your first, your greatest, your best pupil. I'm Zoltan Karpathy, that marvelous boy.
Oh.
I made your name famous throughout Europe. You teach me phonetics, you cannot forget me.
Why don't you have your hair cut?
I don't have your imposing appearance, your figure, your brow. If I had my hair cut, nobody would notice me.
Where did you get all these old coins?
These are decorations for language. The Queen of Transylvania is here this evening. I'm indispensable to her at these official international parties. I speak 32 languages. I know everyone in Europe. No imposter can escape my detection.
Professor Karpathy.
The Greek ambassador. Greek, my foot. He pretends not to know any English, but he cannot deceive me. He's the son of a Yorkshire watchmaker. He speaks English so villainously that he cannot utter a word without betraying his origin. I help him pretend, but I make him pay through the nose. I make them all pay.
Excuse me, sir, you're wanted upstairs. Her Excellency asks you.
Excuse me.
The young lady with Colonel Pickford. Find out who she is.
With pleasure.
Tell me, Zoltan, some more about the Greek ambassador.
Gladly, Professor, but first I would love you to present me to this glorious creature.
You are accused of being a spy in the service of the British Armed Forces. Have you anything to say that might lead this court to believe otherwise?
I told you I was fishing.
This is the gesamte Beweismaterial der Anklage, Herr Kapitän. As your fellow prisoner has already learned, the penalty for not answering this court is death. Will you be so good as to tell us exactly where and how you acquired torpedoes?
Mr. Allnut made them.
How very interesting.
You don't believe me, do you?
Hey, Max, how come they chained a white man to a black?
The warden's got a sense of humor.
What'd he say just now?
He said not to worry about catching them. They probably kill each other before they go 5 miles.
Sally, bring up the
Dobermans. Here we are. Wait a minute.
What's the matter?
No dogs.
Max, do we have to go all over that again?
No killer dogs, Frank.
Look, Max, we crossed the county line this morning. I didn't want to have to bring this up, but you're out of your jurisdiction. Take off the muzzle, Sally.
Wait a minute, Sally.
We're wasting time, Max.
We're supposed to find them, not execute.
I'm giving the orders. Go ahead, Sully.
Just a minute, Sully. You make one move and I'm going to shoot them.
For the love of Mike, Max!
You gonna listen to me?
Hold everything, Sully.
All right. I take those trackers. We close in, I'll go on ahead by myself. Anything happens to me, you can let the other dogs loose. Not before.
I don't like it.
You don't have to.
Pete. That's when we'll make it occur. We'll make it occur at 4 o'clock. At that moment, that precise moment, we shall destroy evil. This is both my charge and my obligation, Pete, to destroy evil. And we shall do it at 4 o'clock. I'm not quite sure of the method yet, but that will come to me. It will come to me assuredly, and it will be a revelation. It will be the expiration of immorality, the exordium of the end. 4 o'clock, Pete. That's when we'll make it happen. Whatever form I choose. 4 o'clock.
That's Oliver Crangle, a dealer in petulance and poison. He's rather arbitrarily chosen 4 o'clock as his personal Gotterdammerung.
It's
happening, Pete. It's happening right now. Everyone, all the evil ones, they're all turning into tiny little gnomes.
Certainly, Peter. This is kind of a celebration.
Remind me very much of my darling Greta. May she rest in peace. Very much like her.
Oh. You know something, Mr. Klemmer? Al. You ought to find yourself another Greta.
Who would want to have a worn-out old buck like me?
Oh, there are lots of women who'd like to have a worn-out old buck like you.
Mrs. Bunker.
Edith.
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 Edith. Are you telling me that I have a chance? I'm having a wonderful time.
Me too. Here's a cute one. Nancy Dokes and Dokes and
Dokes. And little Lancy Divey, a tiddly divey too. You know, I have a confession to make. I never know what the song means.
Neither do I.
Listen. This one is for you. Ich küsse ihre Hand, Madame, und träume es wäre ihr Mund. Ich bin ja so galant, Madame, doch das hat seinen Grund.
Oh. I feel like I'm at the Lawrence Welk show. That's beautiful. What does it mean?
It means I kiss your hand, Madame, and dream it would be more.
Oh.
You have such beautiful hands.
Oh, here's a nice one.
No, please. No more music. Let's just talk.
Oh, all right.
You know, all the times you have been coming into the shop, I was hoping for a time like this when we could be alone together.
Oh, you shouldn't talk like that, Mr. Klemmer.
Al Liebchen.
Al Liebchen.
You don't know what I feel for you.
Oh, no.
Edith.
Please, Mr.